Hello, my name is Florencia del Castillo. I'm from the National Research Center from Patagonia. And I want to introduce, this is the beginning of a project that I am working with the ethnohistorian in Patagonia. And this is the first model that we designed to model seasonal hunting. Well, the model that I'm going to present here specifically represents an historical hunting model from the central Patagonia that it was designed to understand the functionality of collective hunting activities during the summer season in one of the most, for the moment, known inhabitant regions of South America. The region is here, the Somuncura Plateau. I point with the mouse. Well,
yes.
What I'm going to present here is the way we are introducing historical data in a simple model. And the first I want to introduce in the problem, that is the, we are using the exploratory diary of a Swiss explorer, George Claras, who explored Patagonia during 1965 and 1966. And here, the map is pointing out all his trip. He traveled more than 1,000 kilometers long, but what I want to explain is that he started traveling 20 years before the Argentina state entered to the south, Patagonia. So this is an exploration 20 years than the army of the Argentine army explore and stay in Patagonia. So the importance of his diary is that, I don't know, but it's one of the few documents that have when the author brought every day what he was doing during the trip. The important is that he also explained when they wake up, how many hours do they use to hunt, to gather another kind of food or animals, where they pick or they take water. All these details are so well described, because Claras was a naturalist from the 18th century, and he knew a lot about fauna, flora, geography, and geology. And that's the way he described all the things that he was seeing during the trip. Also, the importance is that he starts here at the coast of the Atlantic coast, and on this trip, he had two guys. There are not this man, but these two guys were from different ethnic groups. One belonged, named Manzana, belongs to the well-known Mapuches from the Andes, and the other ones belong to what we know, Tehuelches from the south, who now we know that were completely very different. And they ride by horse during all these more than 20,000 kilometers because they want to reach the Welsh colony who arrived this year to the southern part of, to the middle part of Patagonia, here. And the problem is that he couldn't reach the colony, so he had to return, and then he also described in very detail he returned to Bahia Blanca, he's at the coast of, over the coast. So, this model that I'm going to describe now was proposed to analyze and better understand a simple model of discrete activities of hunter-gatherers. And it is thus mainly designed for testing hypotheses and theory development. I'm not going to show exactly what we were talking all this day about validation. I'm going to describe how I'm going to use this concrete model, a specific model. So, all the activities that he described was something that few people know, that was exactly the camp, the distribution of the camp, how many people were in these places, how do they hunt, with which kind of arms or tools they utilize. And to work with this historical description, I use Atlas T, that is a very useful program that helps to quantify qualitative information. In this case, all the description of his diary that had more than 30 pages was analyzed by Atlas T. And what we can do with that is that we can quantify exactly, using codes, exactly all the information that we are looking for in the diary. So one of the observations is exactly that during when you are, there is marking red here, is what people now know, or the way that he named it, is the Yamnagoo. Yamnagoo is the way that Tehuelche people express a place where there's full of guanacos. And some people also call that the place of the paradise of the Tehuelchen's land, because it was, they said that during this month, 2 months, there were so many guanacos that it was so easy to hunt them, that all the tribes were there during November and October and November. So the place that I'm going to describe is Somoncura Basalt Plateau, and it's also one of the most unknown archaeological places in Patagonia. It's a desert, and the basaltic plateau have levels that are between 1,500 kilometers high. And this place during all the winter is completely intransitable. And during the summer, from August and from August, November and December, start the season of the guanaco reproduction. This is an actual information, the distribution, because it's something that still biologists don't know, how are the guanacos distributed all along the north of Patagonia. This information we are using in the model only the information that Claras gave us. This is the border of the plateau, Somoncura Plateau, and this is the way that the trip of Claras going around the basaltic plateau. So another thing that he described very well is the water resource during this season. And they were mainly, they have water from spring water or streams. You know, as you see in the pictures, it's a very desert land that is very hard during the summer, January and February. This is the model, an old model from 2004 that with another archaeologist, Teresa Boschin and I, present a model using Claras information and also using ethnographical information. Because we made a lot of interviews in this part of the Yamnagoo to check the information about the mobility of the guanaco, that it was something that at the moment we still don't know why. We are guessing that the movement of this guanaco are every year going there. So, as we have presented before, we formulate this model indicating that the movement from the movement of the Tehuelche groups were, I don't know if you see them, I don't see it. When you see Chulengo season, Chulengo is the is a big and small guanaco. It's the time when the guanacas or guanacos, pregnant guanacas, go to that part because it's very difficult to them to go in the upper parts of the basaltic plateau. So the guanaco, during the months of November and October, go there to have the guanacos, the chulengos. And why is important the chulengo in the life of tehuelches and in the mobility also about the tehuelches? Because non-bear chulengos or newborn chulengos are used to something that the only fur that tehuelches use to use. This is the main clothes of tehuelches. And it's only made by small guanacos or not born guanaco. So in the previous model, what we point is that chulengo season is the time that during a collective hunting season, the tehuelches go there to have the fur and then what they describe to the Claras and during the chronicles is that they use a few parts of the guanacos and discard many parts of the guanaco there. So the model that I want, I'm designing the model based on this information, and I only want to model only this part of the seasonal hunting, and is this one. Where do they install their camp? How do they move to reach the guanacos? And how many times do they time to return? These are all the parameters that I'm going to use in the model are all the parameters that were given by Claras. So the simple diagram of the process diagram is this one, the white one, where I indicate how what do tehuelches do during a day during the chulengo season. So they move, they hunt, they decided what kind of guanaco they will select, because they say they only kill in this part of the Patagonia. They say that they only mainly kill fetus or young guanacos. And then I will design the process with different situations, with what happened when they do the same with horse, with a transport, and without a horse, and what they do with cooperative activities or not. So the entities that I'm going to design in the model are hunters, divided in different groups, the three groups, and which differ from capacity, velocity, acceleration, coordination, coalition, time, so to wait for a start one activity, distance to prioritize, and hunting guanacos that also are characterized by fetus, young, and adults. The software that I use, I live in this, for the first time I leave the logo as computer science suggests, but I look for a more simple model platform, and that is FlexSim. I use it because people where I work use it to model production, process of production or process of transport. And that is what I want to use. The way that they introduce the data there and how they describe this sequence of process from the moment that they go out to the camp, they select the animals they want to have, how many times they are going to waste processing the food, processing the leather, and then discarding discarding and taking the parts that they want to the camp again. So this platform, what it basically uses are fixed resources. They have an agent who have many qualities, visual, general, option location, connection between agents, many possibilities to describe of the agent's activity. And it also had a very easy way to express statistical or to take statistics to another programs. And it also had visual tool that is, that's what I'm going to explain later. And it also had a very easy or simple way to define also the ancients, how the parameters are going to introduce. This is just an example. Also the guanacos, that what data I'm introducing, and I'm defining the guanacos movement, decision, or stage. And during the experimental design, what I said before, I'm going to check only these three things. What happened during this very concrete process, if we control the variable of mobility, what happened if we control, we introduce horse? You know that horse was introduced in Patagonia only by Indians during the last 300 years in this part. Also, in which way they coordinate or not coordinate during this sequence of activities. So this is the basic part representation of the model. 2 minutes, okay. First result, that's what I take at the beginning, so how they are going to, what happened during this discrete process if the Asians only walk. Well, I'm going to faster, introducing the horse, and it's easy also to understand the way we design this process, also without coordination, because each time here you can program, how many people are going to participate in the activity, if they have coordination, if they have to wait one each other or not, how is the capacity of each one of the agents. So the first result are sometimes in part obvious and in part not, is that when Asians walk, of course, the quantity of leather, of food that they can take to the camp is less. But it also expresses how many parts of the guanacos they are using, or they catch, fed to guanacos in percentage, and also the different activities and the time that they take to each one of the agents to process all parts of the, all the parts of the, this process. Well, why I bring here this small model? First, because I'm working with ethnohistorical researchers, and first, because it was something that it was very easy to use when you share or try to build a model based in historical with a lot of people or the historian helping you to understand or fixing the parameters that you are using. And then because it's also when you introduce this discrete functionality, because this model is completely functional, it's also a good way to show the people who are the reception of this to traduce or to express or to communicate in which way you are designing this small process. So I think it's maybe it's a tool that I'm just introducing because people from transport are using it, but in concrete simulations. But I also think that maybe it had more potential to communicate all the data and all the results data when you all don't work with people that don't come from computer science and also come from social science. And for the archaeological purpose, also it's a good way to test how chronicles and how historical data sometimes is taken to understand the use of some places when you almost have any capacity to or possibility to make excavations or have some here in this site that you have you see here. They are also superficial, and in only 1972 there were only was one carbon data, and after 1972 there were another possibility or another archaeology that go there to obtain some carbon data analysis. Well, I don't know if I can keep.
Thank you very much.